So here's an actual implementation from the DARPA Urban Challenge, the Stanford car, trying to find a way to a maze. And as you can see, the maze is changing as the car moves. This reflects of the fact that the car uses its sensors to see obstacles, and obstacles are sometimes occluded, and the car can only see them when they're nearby. What's really remarkable here is that the car is able to plan really complex maneuvers to the goal. At any point in time, you can see its best guess of a path to the goal. And the orange trees are A-star search trees. They aren't exactly grid trees. Our car moves differently from a grid-based robot. It can turn at different angles. And each of these little steps is a different turning angle combined with a different forward motion. But leaving this aside, you get these amazing trees that find paths all the way to the goal using A-star. This implementation is so fast that it can plan these paths in less than 10 milliseconds for any location in this maze. That was faster than any other driving team that I know of at the DARPA Grand Challenge or the DARPA Urban Challenge. The planning is repeated every time the robot cancels the previous plan. You can see additional adjustments at place at times. But as you go through this video, you can see how A-star planning with a simple Euclidean distance heuristic is able to find a path to the goal. When you implement this yourself, the big difference to our grid implementation is a different motion model. You have to implement a robot that is able to turn, and you have to write on the math of a robot that's able to turn and go forward. This robot also can revert, so going backwards is a discrete different action. But other than that, it's essentially the same A-star algorithm you just implemented. So if you want to build a self-driving car, you now understand to make a really complex, nice search algorithm to find a path to a goal. So this is a scene where DARPA trapped our car using a barrier that went all across the street. So the only way for the car to navigate this was to take a multiple U-turn and had to plan this all by itself using A-star planning. The car pulls up to the barrier, realizes there's no path to go, then invokes its A-star planner and comes up with a turnaround maneuver that is not particularly elegant, but it's super effective. And the car was able, in this competition, by itself, to turn around using A-star, find the optimal plan to do so, and move on. Otherwise, it would have been stuck forever behind this obstacle. In this final video, I'll show you a parking situation where the car has to back into a parking space between two other cars. And you can see how the obstacles are visible, how these other cars are visible, and how our vehicle Junior navigates an actual parking lot. Again, this is using A-star. It finds its way optimally into this parking spot, backs in and backs out again all by itself. The planning time for each of these A-star runs is less than 10 milliseconds. And the car was able to competently do this, even though in advance they had no clue where the obstacles were and where the parking spot was. That is A-star for robot path planning. And what you've implemented yourself is the core of it. Again, if you want to turn it into a real robotic motion algorithm, you have to change the motion model. And you have to see the next class I'm teaching you when I go to continuous values and show how to turn this into a continuous motion path.